Food is a human right, not a privilege. Yet last year saw the biggest increase in hungry people for 50 years, with 118 million more people going to bed hungry each day. Hunger kills hopes and dreams.
This is why the Zero Hunger Coalition is needed. It brings together member states, UN agencies, civil society organizations, and businesses. Our goal is simple: reduce the number of people suffering from hunger to zero by 2030.
Thanks to science and research, we know how to most effectively reduce hunger while at the same time improving incomes and protecting the environment. High impact actions need to be implemented everywhere, especially where there's a high burden of hunger.
With higher and more diverse food production potential, Pakistan can support its malnourished and vulnerable population. Pakistan is also committed to join the Zero Hunger Coalition for seeking technical assistance and sharing experiences for achieving national and international zero hunger goals.
We need to empower the excluded. The priorities, knowledge, and skills of smallholder food producers, youth, indigenous peoples, and women are key to ending hunger.
Norway commits to supporting farmers with securing access to seeds that meet local needs. This supports production of diverse and nutritious food.
Small and medium-sized enterprises serve consumers in every corner of the world. They are central to combating hunger.
We know that the future of food security depends on making food production a more attractive livelihood to the young generations.
Ireland commits to tackling wasting and acute hunger through political and financial commitments. An investment in nutrition is an investment in our future.
Nigeria prioritizes agricultural transformation and children's nutrition. The Zero Hunger Coalition can help to support our priorities through setting up SPARC partnerships, sharing learnings, and offering technical support.
Many businesses around the world are signing the Zero Hunger Pledge, committing to align their operations and their investments with high-impact actions to reduce hunger.
But this will never be enough if we don't target conflict areas and make sure that food is never used as a weapon again.
Through humanitarian efforts, we create safety nets for those most at risk from hunger and malnutrition: mothers, infants, and young children.
Achieving zero hunger also means understanding its trade-offs and how to minimize them. The UN and its partners must engage in country-level dialogues and food system transformation pathways, attracting the investment necessary to achieve sustainable food systems and zero hunger. We can achieve zero hunger by 2030 together.